Hello, and welcome. Following many requests, this week I tested Ryujinx for Android. As you know, it's still a work in progress, but this emulator already outperforms others in some aspects. Today, I'll show you some games running on it, and explain how to install it if you want to try it out yourself. Before we start, make sure to hit that like button to support more tests like this. And if it's your first time here, consider subscribing to receive more content about emulation. For those interested in testing Ryujinx, the link with all the necessary files is in the description. In it, you'll find the APK, which is the installation file for Android. However, just installing the APK isn't enough, the emulator also requires system files. Trying to install these files directly through the emulator's interface will cause an error. To fix this, first install the app and grant it permission to access your device's files. Then, unzip the provided files, go to the Ryujinx folder, copy all the files, and paste them into Android data or .ryujinx.android files, replacing the old files. If done correctly, when you open Ryujinx and go to settings, the firmware version displayed will be 18. Now, for those who don't know, here's a quick overview of the setup I used for testing. The device is a ROG Phone 6 with 8GB of RAM and a Snapdragon 8 Plus Gen 1 processor. All capture was done using an external card, so the results you'll see weren't affected by recording software. All games ran at 720p, since the goal here is to test what the emulator can run, not to provide benchmarks. It's important to note that since this is a work-in-progress project, there are still some issues. Sometimes, a game runs fine but the app encounters an error and needs to be closed. If this happens, just try opening the game again. In some cases, you might need to try 3 times before the game runs on your device. Without further ado, let's check out the games. Alex Kidd and Miracle World DX took a while to boot, but when it finally ran, the performance was flawless, with stable 60 FPS. However, I did notice slight input delay specific to this game. There are no graphical issues, which is impressive compared to other emulators that often display several visual glitches when running this title. Bayonetta 3 was the only game I've tested so far that Ryujinx for Android can actually boot, although boot might be an overstatement. The game does run but encounters severe graphical and shader compilation issues, resulting in visual glitches. On my device, the frame rate stayed below 30 FPS, making the gameplay quite sluggish. Castlevania Dominus Collection had already received optimizations before the Ryujinx project went down. Despite this, the game experiences instabilities at launch. However, if you manage to run it on the first try, you can enjoy long gameplay sessions without major performance drops or emulator bugs. Dragon Ball FighterZ is notoriously difficult to run on Yuzu Forks, requiring specific patches, updates, and hacks to work properly. On Ryujinx, the game runs in a very rudimentary state, with the character selection screen failing to load, showing a red background instead. During gameplay, many objects are not rendered properly, showing only their primary colors. There are also missing UI elements, such as health bars, special meters, and combo counters. The frame rate stays below 30 FPS, leading to significant slowdowns. Mario Kart 8 has fewer frequent crashes compared to Yuzu Forks, but the overall performance isn't much better. The game still has several shader issues and experiences slowdowns at times. However, the infamous freezes that occur in Yuzu were not observed here. New Super Mario Bros., which is practically Nintendo's Sonic Mania and runs on almost any device with a screen, worked perfectly on Ryujinx without graphical, sound, or performance issues. Unlike the showcases by the Strato team, which only show Pokémon Scarlet in outdoor environments, here we're presenting a more realistic test in varied settings. In outdoor areas like houses and villages, the game runs smoothly at a solid 30 FPS. However, in open-world areas, which make up most of the game, the frame rate drops to a fixed 20 FPS, causing slowdowns that discourage players from attempting to emulate the game on Ryujinx. Other than this performance drop, there are no significant graphical issues. In Pokémon Sword, we experience similar problems to Pokémon Scarlet. The game remains stable at 30 FPS indoors, but in open areas, where most of the game takes place, performance drops to around 24 FPS. The most frustrating part is that in both games, Ryujinx doesn't seem to be using the full potential of the device's hardware. This suggests that with a bit more development, Ryujinx could become the leading Nintendo Switch emulator for Android. Super Mario Odyssey is another very challenging game for emulation. It runs well, practically only on Yuzu, where various hacks have been implemented to improve performance. However, on Ryujinx, the performance is acceptable. While we don't hit 60 FPS in either of the two tested environments, I wouldn't say the game is unplayable due to lack of performance. The average was between 40 to 50 FPS, and if we use a mod to limit the game to 30 FPS, the gameplay would be practically perfect. It's important to remember that Ryujinx still isn't fully utilizing the device's hardware, so with more optimizations, we can expect solid performance. Super Mario Wonder, on the other hand, doesn't perform perfectly either, but it's in a better state compared to other projects. There are some issues with distant objects flickering, and the performance doesn't always stay locked at 60 FPS, causing stutters in certain parts of the stages. This seems to be an optimization problem, not necessarily related to shaders. Yoshi's Crafted World, which struggles in many other projects, is relatively stable here but far from perfect. Occasional graphical glitches cause the game to flicker, which can be annoying during long gameplay sessions. The soundtrack seems to be out of sync with the original, which detracts from the experience, and the game has slowdowns in some moments. Lastly, the final game I tested was Zelda Tears of the Kingdom. I didn't have the patience to reach the outdoor areas, but right in the initial cave, I encountered several shader issues, defective lighting, and poor overall performance. Therefore, I don't recommend using Ryujinx for this game in the current stage of development. I tested other games that didn't run, and I'll leave the list of them in the pinned comment. To conclude, this project had all the potential to become the best Nintendo Switch emulator for Android so far. All the tests you saw in this video were conducted without an optimized Turnip driver, using only the available Adreno driver on the device, which is outdated since manufacturers don't care about updating GPU drivers, unlike what happens with Windows. The Ryujinx team was already preparing to port everything natively to ARM, which explains the decent performance even at this early stage. However, as the developers themselves mentioned, they were facing issues with the available Android drivers, so support is currently limited. If someone capable manages to continue and complete this project after the dust settles regarding the issues with Nintendo, there is a great possibility that Ryujinx could become the definitive Nintendo Switch emulator for Android. This is due to the fact that we have many people testing and sharing their results, unlike Strato, where only two people test and show the public only what they want. If you'd like, I can make a video comparing the games running on Sudachi and Ryujinx so you know which emulator is performing better currently. But for now, Sudachi is the most recommended. And that's it for today's video. Thanks for watching, and see you next time!